Well, hello everybody, welcome to this next video. So in the last video we have talked about what is a series and we had defined it as an infinite sum. We said that an infinite sum is called a series. So in this particular video we are going to talk about the convergence of the series, and by convergence of the series, which we have already defined, convergence of series means the sum is finite, means the sum of the series is finite. This is what we mean by the convergence of the series. So here, what we are going to do, we are going to define a method in which we have, you know, something quantitative that we can judge whether the sum is going to be finite or not. So for that, what we are going to do, suppose you have this sequence. So this sequence, it is never ending. It's like, because they are infinite terms. Now if I ask you, suppose you have like stairs, you have to reach here, this is your destination and this is your starting point. When you go from here to there and there are stairs, what do you do? Do you directly go from here to here, so, or you go one at a time? So generally, in the ideal case, we go one at a time. Sometimes somebody can jump and he or she can go like two at a time. But this is the general case, like we go one at a time. So here also, we'll apply the same strategy. We are going to add one term at a time. Okay, so what we are going to do, first of all, we'll consider only one term. So we will just have A1. Then we are going to consider first two terms. So basically, I'm going to add in my first term the second term. I'll call it as S1, I'll call it as S2. Now I already have S2, then S3 is, I want to add one more term in S2, so this is S2 plus A3. Now already I have S3, now I want to add one more term, that is A4, so S4 is S3 plus A4, and then similarly I can keep on doing this. This is S4 plus A5 and so on. So generally what I'm doing, I'm creating a sequence. Now this is a sequence. Now if I openly write the terms of the sequence, how the terms look, so you have S1 equal to A1, you will have S2 equal to A1 plus A2, S3 is equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3, S4 is equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4, and so on, Sn is equal to A1 plus A2 plus An. Now, can you do this process? Is it possible for you to do this particular process? The answer is yes, because we know how to add one term, and in this particular process we are just adding one term every time. For example, if you have S1, you are just adding S1 in S1 A2. If you have S2, you are just adding A3 in S2. Now you have S3, you are just adding A4 in S3. So this is a process you are familiar with, but you are not familiar with adding infinite terms. That cannot be done actually, right? So okay, this is one thing. Now if you look at the terms of the sequence, they are like this. So what do you expect? As n goes to infinity, this Sn is going to be A1 plus A2 plus A3 up to infinity, which is nothing but your original sequence, original series sum. So it means that if we can find out a finite limit for the sequence of partial sums, these sums are called partial sums. Si's are called partial sums. Generally, Sn is called Snth partial sum. Right. Now, if we can find out a limit for the sequence Sn, so let me write down completely. If given a series sigma An, you construct a sequence of partial sums, and already we have studied about the sequence of the limits of the sequence, then find the limit of the sequence. Find limit of sequence, this sequence. If limit n tending to infinity Sn is equal to a unique finite number, say L, then the series is convergent and its sum is L. Okay, and if limit and tending to infinity, Sn is infinity or does not exist, then it implies series is divergent. So you don't have the sum of the series. So this is the logical explanation of why we construct a sequence from the series and then we find the limit of that sequence. This is done because we don't know how to add infinite numbers, and here we can see that as n goes to infinity, the sequence terms, they are nothing but they are moving closer and closer to your sum of the series, right? I'll just give you example, but this is the crude way of checking the convergence. But it is not possible always, because this is, you know, you have to construct a sequence first, then you have to look for its nth term. So basically these are the steps you have to do. You have to construct given a series an, then you have to construct sn, then you have to, because if you want sn means you are looking for nth term. Sometimes it is not, you know, clearly observable that what is the nth term. Then you have to find the limit. So this task looks simple, but it is, you know, pretty complicated task. So generally we avoid this route, but this is the basic route, and for some videos from now onwards we will use this route, and after that we will shift to some more, you know, modern ideas of checking the convergence of the series. Now let me give you an example. Suppose I have this series 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 16 plus 1 by 32 and so on, and I am looking for whether this sum exists or not. So this is actually 1 upon 2 raised to power n minus 1 and from 1 to infinity. So this is the series we are having. I am looking for whether the sum of the series exists or not, or in other words, is this series convergent? So as I explained above, I am going to construct the sequence of partial sums. So my S1 is the first term, that is 1. S2 is the sum of the first two terms, that is 3 by 2. S3 is equal to 3 by 2 plus 1 more term, that is 1 by 4. This is equal to, you have LCM as 4, then 6 plus 1, this is 7 by 4, right? And then S4 is your 7 by 4 plus 1 more term, that is 8. This is 8 is LCM, 14 plus 1, this is 15 by 8. And then S5 is your 15 by 8 plus 1 more term, that is 1 by 16. So this is 16, 30 plus 1, this is 31 by 16, and so on. So this is the, first of all, I have constructed the sequence of partial sums. Now I have to look for the nth term of the sequence. So can I write, this is just like, for this particular case, I can see that this first term is 2 minus 1. The second term is 2 minus 1 by 2. The third term is 2 minus 1 by 4. Can you see that? This is 2 minus 1 by 8. This is 2 minus 1 by 16, and so on. So it means that, you see here, 2 minus 1 by 2 raised to power 0. This is 2 minus 1 by 2 raised to power 1. This is 2 minus 1 by 2 raised to power 2. This is 2 minus 1 by 2 raised to power 3. This is 2 minus 1 by 2 raised to power 4. So it means that for S5 you have here 4. So I observed that Sn is 2 minus 1 by 2 raised to power n minus 1. So I got my nth term of the sequence. Now I have to find limit n going to infinity Sn. This is equal to limit n going to infinity 2 minus 1 by 2 raised to power n minus 1. So this is 2 minus limit n going to infinity 1 upon 2 raised to power minus 2 raised to power n minus 1. So this limit, as 2 raised to power infinity is infinity, so 1 upon infinity is 0. So this limit is 2. It means that we got a finite and unique limit. It implies the given series is convergent. Given series is convergent and its sum is 2. So here you can see, here was a series whose nth term for the sequence of partial sums we easily guessed, but this will not be the case always. But this should be very clear to you. This is applicable everywhere. Given any series, this is the basic definition of the convergence of the series. So let me repeat, given a series, by convergence we mean that the series has a finite sum, and or we can say that the sequence of partial sums for that particular series is convergent. So this is the equivalent definition for the convergence of the series. So we say that sigma an is convergent if sequence of partial sums sigma Sn is convergent, where Sn is equal to sum of the n terms of the series. Okay, so we'll see that how we can dig more into the convergence of the series in the coming videos. Thank you.